These 5 tips will save you hours on editing reels, TikToks, and shorts in CapCut and on creating short form video content in general. After watching this video, you'll know how to use CapCut's nifty little features to edit like a pro. Ready? Let's do this. Hi, my lovely people, it's Natalia, and welcome back to my channel where I help you create better content and grow on social media. Editing videos can be daunting, and it's no different in the case of reels, shorts, or TikToks. In this video, I'm sharing my 5 favorite tips to edit faster in CapCut and create video content much quicker. There's no time to waste, and let's start with tip number 1, use a teleprompter. The key to a more efficient editing process is preparation. That's why for my talking head reels or TikToks, I create a script to make sure I get my point across quickly, I don't ramble too much, and the video has a proper structure with a strong hook and a call to action. But this is just a part of the tip I've got for you. Once you have your mini script ready and have roughly planned the shots you need, use the CapCut teleprompter feature to record your reel. This is a recent update within the app, and it's truly a game changer. Not only does it make the recording so much easier, but also speeds up the editing process by a long shot. You're not wasting your precious time in the editor trying to find the best shots because it's easier to record with no mistakes using a teleprompter. Besides, your shots are a lot more cohesive since your energy is not dwindling as fast while recording, and you can maintain a similar vibe and pace throughout. All of this, of course, means you're spending less time adjusting your clips and sound to make it nice and smooth. To do this, open the CapCut app on your phone, make sure it's updated to the latest version, and on the homepage right here at the top is our prompter. If you tap on it, you're taken to a recording screen looking very similar to the one you may know from TikTok, and a prompter panel is right in the middle. First, I make sure to select the 3-minute timer since I don't want to be restricted in any way, and choose the mode here at the very bottom. The one-shot option means you're just recording the whole thing with no breaks, and the multi-clips option allows you to record multiple clips that then show up on your timeline, which I'll show you in a moment. Now I can tap on the edit icon here in the middle to paste my text. Let me switch up to Notion to my planned post and copy the script. Let's paste it here, and I like to add 3 to 5 dots here at the top to give myself a moment extra to get in position on top of the standard 3-second timer after I press record. Now, with this settings icon, you can adjust the speed and font size and change the color of the text too, which is very useful for the different types of settings you'll be recording your videos in. And you can also move this prompter box around with this 4th side icon. Okay, let's hit record, and I'll just record the intro. All right, as you can see, when I stopped, I have this clip right here on the recorder with a 5-second mark too, and let's record the next paragraph. Now, if I don't like a clip, I can just tap this X arrow here, and it's going to ask if I want to delete the last clip. Oftentimes, when I'm not actually certain which shot I prefer, I'll leave the one here and record an alternative one because I can remove them from the editor later on after comparing them in the playback. Okay, I've finished recording my script. I'll tap this green check mark here, and we're taken to the playback panel where I can just add effects, text, voiceover, adjust clips, etc. Or if I want a more elaborate edit with B-roll or masking or whatever else I have planned for this, I can just hit edit at the very bottom, and it's going to take me to the CapCut editor too. Of course, I can also save it at this stage using the save button. Let's hit edit. And as you can see, the clips are already cut on the timeline for you, saving you a ton of time with the editing process. Tip number 2, record to replace. Here's my favorite tip to speed up your reels editing process and your content creation workflow too. After a heavy writing session when I churn out multiple reel scripts, I'll record some of them by literally grabbing my phone, pointing it at something, and reading the script out loud just as I would a voiceover. Then I go to CapCut, I upload the script, detach audio using this icon right here, and make cuts like this in places where I want my B-roll clips to appear. I keep them in drafts for my editing day, and when I'm ready, I record or source B-roll footage and save it on my phone. Then I go back to my project in CapCut, tap the clip I want to swap and choose replace, then select the B-roll clip and find the right moment for it. I do the same thing for all my cuts, and I end up with an intro to swap out, and I usually have a ton of them pre-recorded too. The replace feature in CapCut is a time saver when it comes to my editing process, and it streamlines my content creation because I can quickly record my scripts right after I finish writing. Besides, it's keeping my reel snappy and to the point, and swapping out B-roll is much easier than trying to make my voiceover fit the footage. I don't have any awkward pauses there, I don't struggle with pacing myself, and my reel just flows naturally and smoothly. The only thing I have to worry about is not speaking too fast, which I definitely tend to do, so that there's enough time for the B-roll clips. Tip number 3, organize your folders. to edit much faster, create a folder for yourself containing all the important brand assets that you always use. This way you will have all of them at hand right when you need them, and you won't have to jump between apps constantly searching for something. Whether you need your brand color palette, some stickers or overlays that you use often, backdrop images, animations, anything that represents your brand or is something that you use all the time within your content, keep them all saved nicely on your phone in a brand folder. It means whenever you edit in CapCut, you can just change the default folder from recents to this folder and pull up the important assets with just a few taps. I also like to keep a second folder with all my own stock footage containing clips like hyperlapses of me working, the pre-recorded intros I've mentioned in the first tip, or any other videos I can use to create my content easily. I talk about this in a bit more detail in this video right here, where I share my 4 top productivity hacks for content creators, so I highly recommend you watch it next. And of course, we're just talking about your phone here, but if you ever edit anything on your laptop or tablet, do the exact same thing across your other devices too, because having crucial asset folders organized and ready to go is such a time saver. You can just drag and drop all your files from that folder into your editing program and use them quickly, again, without jumping from one place to the other. Tip number 4, add captions automatically. Another way you can save time while editing is to include auto-generated captions through CapCut. Not only are you making your content accessible to all members of your audience, but you're also not wasting any time fixing the captions later when posting and adding them on Instagram or TikTok. After all, even if you use the auto-caption sticker, they don't always come out right, and editing them from the Reels panelology is such a pain. Sure, CapCut is not going to perfectly transcribe your content, but the correcting part is much smoother there, and you're already in the mindset of editing your videos instead of scrambling when you should be able to just hit publish. To do this in CapCut, go to your project, tap the text icon in the bottom panel, and select the auto captions option. From here, you can choose your sound source, select language, you can identify filler words, pauses, turn on dynamic captions, and just generate them. Then you can just hit batch edit for the seamless correction I've mentioned, so you can just tap and correct. Once you're happy, tap the A icon in the left corner to apply a style to your captions, and you can choose a font or add your own. You can choose a style, change color, make it bigger or transparent. You can add shadow, space the letters out, so many different options here. Then you have different effects, animation, or even speech bubbles to use, so it's super customizable and definitely much more powerful than relying on native captions like the ones on Instagram. The fact that CapCut auto-transcribes your video for you is a massive time saver, meaning that you can add captions with just a few clicks and focus on the more important things. Tip number 5, edit on beat. Whenever you use music or music-based audios, you can help yourself with editing by using the beat sync feature in CapCut. It automatically identifies the beat for you, which you can then use to create your cuts and effortlessly sync your clips to the track. This, of course, is another fantastic way to save time while editing, and definitely saves you the frustration of having to manually identify the peaks on an audio track. To do this, first add the music you want to use on your project by either extracting it from a video, choosing it from the library, or just uploading your file. Then tap on the track and from the bottom panel, select beats. You can tap the button in the middle to add them manually while playing, but I prefer to just toggle the auto-generate option and let CapCut do its thing for me. When it does, you have 2 options for beats. One is usually a more sparse beat, and the second one works with the main beat, which from my experience is what you'll want 90% of the time. As you can see, the beats appear on your track. Next, you can zoom in on the timeline by using 2 fingers to make it easier for yourself to see those beats. Tap your clip and start splitting it. You can then remove the parts you no longer need, rearrange them by dragging and dropping, or again using the replace feature if a particular clip ruins the vibe. Super quick and easy. Which of these CapCut editing tips was your favorite? I'd love to know if you're going to use them, and if you do, hit the thumbs up so I know I should create more content like this. And speaking of, make sure you watch my full Reels tutorial right here to learn how to create amazing Reels in the Instagram app. Subscribe to my channel to level up your social media skills. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.